So HydroFLEX is the UK's first hydrogen train. It's also the world's first bimode electric hydrogen train. And today has been a historic day because it's been the first day we have seen a hydrogen train running on the UK mainline railway as we left here at Longmaster and went up to Evesham and back successfully.
It takes a lot of work to get a hydrogen train to run on the mainline. There's a huge amount of safety approvals work that we have to go through. We've had to formally document a lot of things, record things, assess the hazards, assess the risks.
Hydrogen is really important in terms of being able to offer decarbonisation solutions to the rail industry, mainly because you can produce hydrogen from renewable sources by electrolysing water. And hydrogen is going to be used on the parts of the railway which is just not economic to electrify.
I can't describe how proud I am of the whole HydroFLEX team to get the first UK mainline hydrogen train working. It's been absolutely fantastic project. And it's a personal highlight for me of the career. And also it's a real big step forward to the UK and decarbonisation of the railway.
One of the best things about being at the University of Birmingham is we do really, really good practical and industrially focused research, and we've always done a record of doing that. And we developed this partnership with Porterbrook just over 2 years ago. And Porterbrook, from my point of view, have been a really innovative company and willing to take a risk on the technology and working in partnership with us to get to where we are today with the HydroFLEX train.
So I'm right here in the West Midlands where I've just been for a journey on this hydrogen train, a UK first, actually in many senses a world first, a train powered only by hydrogen but runs just like a regular diesel train without the smell, without the noise and of course without pumping out CO2.
It's been so exciting for the team to draw together all that work that we've put in and to see it running at high speed on the network. And more importantly, to the industry to demonstrate this technology is the future.